is one of the lower totals of the week. The Saints visiting the Patriots. So the spread here opened New England -2.5 last week on the look ahead. And we've seen some money on the dog since. And now we're kind of floating in that 1-1.5 range. I didn't think the Saints looked great last week. Obviously, the Patriots look like absolute garbage, but they were facing maybe the best defense in the NFL. Derek Carr is hurt. Patriots offense can't move the ball. This feels like a tough watch, guys. So help me make some money in what should probably be a very ugly game for the eyeballs. Chris, you're starting with a little play on the underdog here.
Yeah, this fits kind of the same criteria as the Titans do, where I like the Saints in teaser mode the most. I think that that's the optimal way to play them. This line is begging you to take New England. So it tells you, it reminds me of Tennessee last week against Cincinnati. You look at that and never hits three. That tells you Tennessee's the right side of the game. And the Sharps came in and figured that out, you know, close to the post. And this game seems very similar. New England just lost two of their best defensive players on top of the issues that they already have. We already know the offense is, you know, like the Keystone Cops over there. So, the Saints, they aren't much better. You know, when you have 11 passes to your running back, Kamara, for 33 yards, that's a problem. But that's his first game back after a long layoff. So I look for players to come in slow on that first game, and I look for him to be at game speed for this game. And I think that that will be a benefit. And Carr, they should have yanked him at the half, and they didn't. Hopefully they don't go through the same nonsense. Either he's there to show up, and he does well, or maybe they make a change of quarterback to kind of disrupt things. It was the first time in 12 games that the Saints gave up more than 20 points. So their defense has been on spot most of the year, you know, for a long period of time. The model clearly likes the Saints here. I'm going with the model. I bet them straight up, and I bet them on teasers over the 7.5.
Yeah, and just to emphasize, you do have to get the Saints to 7.5 if you tease. Current number at Pick'em, can't tease that. You know, I watched the rewind, and I'm a big believer, a proponent of watching games if you can. It's just I don't consider it to be a very good usage of your time to spend, you know, 3 hours watching one game. But the NFL rewind is a great thing to do. Kamara, I thought, looked great, Chris. He actually, I know, I saw the stats, and I'm like, oh, dude's not ready to play. It's not his fault. No, there's nowhere to run. I mean, he looked explosive. I couldn't believe he couldn't get any yardage. I agree with Chris, you know, as far as looking for a teaser. My play in this game, I hope Jared's right and it is a snooze fest, because I am indeed on the under 40. I went back and the Saints, you know, if you played under the last 10 games in the Saints, you're 10-0. And you're 10-0 under 40.5, also under 40. And only twice has either team in those games scored over 20 points. So this has just been, the Saints are a dead nut under team, and the market hasn't embraced it enough, even with some defensive injuries. New England, I don't think we're going to see any more of this rolling out to the right and throwing back against your body. It's similar to that. Remember that movie, The Program, where James Caan screams to his backup quarterback, don't throw it. And boom, the pick six at the end of the first half. And he's like, clean up this mess. You're starting second half. You getting the good guy back in. By the way, if you haven't checked it out, the BetUS college football team does a great job. Gary, Kyle, Parker. I'd be remiss not to mention every number is important. I just trivialized the value of the 11. And just last week, well, Minnesota beat Louisiana Lafayette by 11.
I pushed on that game. I got a bad number, Fez. I got 11. I needed 11.5 for that.
It was anywhere from 9 to 13 throughout the week on that game. So when I say a number isn't important, every number is important. And the guys at BetUS College Football will let you know which games to invest in.
Appreciate that plug. They do a fantastic job. The baseball show also, we're getting baseball comments in the chat. Ed Blust is asking if the Rays are going to score another run. I don't know. I wish they scored one in the first inning in this game. They didn't. Neither did the Rangers. So we're off to a bad start with our Gurfy bet. So, yeah, check out all the BetUS family of sporting podcasts and shows to get you set for all these great games.
Jared, how do you get off to a bad start on a Gurfy? It's over with, right?
Oh, it's done. No, a bad start on the day. I bet all four of them. All right. So I took your advice. Again, we won't do too much more with your Yurphy chat, but we're betting all the Yurphies in the playoffs. That's just what we do. No play for me in this particular game. I love the under move. There's two things to keep an eye on for me injury-wise this week and player tracking-wise. One, Saints offensive line, Cesar Ruiz. He's one of the best offensive line, one of the best guards in football. Been kind of banged up the last couple weeks. Keep an eye on him. And also, the Patriots just made a move for J.C. Jackson. They traded for the Chargers corner, who was a healthy scratch last week. Of course, Christian Gonzalez, the star rookie, out indefinitely with an injury. And he looked like one of the better young corners in the league through the first few weeks. So that's a big loss for the Patriots. But they filled that void this week with J.C. Jackson. So all the trends, all the vibes look to the under here. I didn't bet it, but I agree with Fez. And how about this, Fez? This will help you out, too. The Saints have failed to score 20 in 11 straight games. It's tough to win in the NFL when you don't get to 20. So that's a magic number to keep an eye on this week, as Chris hopes they get there because he's on the Saints, and Fez is back in the under in the Saints-Pats game.